So you just started playing Albion Online, and as a PvE player, you're wondering what is actually here to do for you. Can this game actually offer you the content you so much desire? As a PvE player, brother, by the end of this video, that question shall be answered. But just a heads up, the answer is absolutely yes! And I'm gonna explain everything that you can do in this game and show you exactly why I'm saying that. As a solo player in Albion Online, it seems like you have way too many options and you might not know exactly what to start with. And at the same time, you might also feel like you have no options, in which case you might be tempted to just say that, hey, this game has no PvE, which couldn't be further away from the truth. Because you see, as a solo player, since you started playing the game till the very late endgame, it's very much worth it to get into what's called solo dungeons, those green portals that you see spawned all across the map. Those dungeons can be as easy as you want them to be or as hard as you want them to be. As a new player, you probably did yourself a bunch of like tier 4 or maybe even tier 5 solo dungeons, and probably you find them pretty tough at the moment. But in a few days, you will probably feel like they're insanely easy to do. Well, when that happens, just like your gear progresses, those dungeons also progress in tiers. So you can go from tier 5 to tier 6 to tier 7 to tier 8. And again, just like your gear, they also have enchantments. So there are 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, all the way to 8.3 dungeons, meaning they scale in difficulty and in rewards like crazy, making them one of the most rewarding solo activities to do in this game. Honestly, as a new PvE player, those solo dungeons can scratch your PvE itch for a long time, but not forever. But that's where the next entry on the list comes in: Rhodes chests. The thing with Rhodes of Avalon chests is that they're insanely good for rewards and they're really fun to do, but they involve a little bit more risk. You see, for solo dungeons, once you get in and wait for 90 seconds, which you should always do, your dungeon entrance closes, meaning that nobody can come in behind you to kill you. So that means that after 90 seconds, you are absolutely safe and you can clear the dungeon however you want. In the Rhodes of Avalon, that doesn't exist, you see? There are some dungeons over there, but we're not talking about those, we're talking about the chests. The chests in the Rhodes of Avalon are completely in the open, meaning that at any point you might run into players that want to kill you. But like everything in this game, the higher the risk, the higher the reward. What you need to know about the Rhodes of Avalon as a new player is that it's a black zone, meaning that you can get killed, and if you get killed, you will lose everything you have. But again, from my experience, the risk is almost always worth the reward. And I have some guides showing some really cheap builds that you can use to not waste so much money when you first start off. The next entry on the list is something very much new. It actually came with the last update: open world bosses. Don't get me wrong, open world bosses were a thing before this update. But now, oh boy, they're one of the best things that you can do as a solo player. The easiest way of explaining to you the system is like this. Think about it as a bounty hunting system. You are the bounty hunter and your quest is to find the oldest mobs living, because the older the mobs are, the stronger they are and the more rewards they will give you. They think about it like they level up over time, something like that. So you can literally have a lot of fun as a solo player just roaming the open world, making some friends on the way and killing those bosses. This, for me at least at the moment, is by far the most amazing solo open world experience. But maybe you're not into solo play. You see, when you first saw this game, you showed it to your friends, they got just as excited as you were, and you all started playing this game. And so you want to find some activities that you can do together. But you don't yet want to get into PvP. You want to stick to PvE for a while until you get used to the game, which is a very good choice. Well, this game has a lot to offer for groups. Well, first of all, you have group dungeons, which you can do with a group up to 5 players. I mean, you could go in with a 20-man group, but I would say don't go with more than 5 players. Usually the team comp is like 1 healer, 1 tank and 3 DPS. That should be more than enough. They're very similar to solo dungeons, you might even recognize some of the layouts, but the bosses are much more interesting, are much more engaging. You actually have to pay attention, you have to synchronize for certain bosses. You might get a legendary chest at the end. There's a rule over there: if you get the 5th floor, you automatically get a legendary boss. And the legendary bosses are like raid bosses in other MMORPGs. They're really cool to just kill and have fun. It's awesome. It's awesome overall. The group dungeons are by far one of the most fun activities to do when it comes to Albion Online PvE content. But there is actually something I enjoy a little bit more. But you need a little bit more experience to get into it. But hey, this is a video meant to show you what this game can offer when it comes to PvE. And oh boy, does the next entry deliver. Avalonian Raids. This is by far, in my opinion, the highest PvE content that you can get yourself into. Even though some people might argue that the next entry is the highest tier PvE content. But let me present my case. For Avalonian Dungeons, you have to get a 20-man group wearing really high item power. So it depends, as they go from tier 6 to tier 8.3. So for tier 6, you don't need as high IP, but you need pretty high IP either way. There's usually 3 healers, 2 of them focusing on the group, 1 of them focusing on the tank. There's 2 tanks, there's a lot of DPS, there's arcanes. It's crazy fun. Everybody needs to know what they're doing or we all die. The simple mobs that you find in an Avalonian raid are like 10 times stronger than the bosses you find even in tier 8 zones, I think, to be honest. They have like hundreds of K in HP. It's really tough to kill them and you actually have to synchronize very, very well with your team to be able to pull it off. This is, I feel like, honestly, the closest thing Albion Online has to other MMORPG raids. But this involves the highest amount of risk possible. Because you see, not only that you need to bring really high item power. Like for my last Avalonian dungeon, I had to go 8.3. My whole set was like 10 million silver. That's a month of premium right there. But the thing is that you do all of this in the black zone. Meaning that people can come and kill you. And there are a lot of people that wanna come and kill us. And it's a really cool thing. You have to take a few safety measures. There's a player scouting. It's really cool how everything works and yeah, I love it. But the experience is priceless. Like one of my favorite moments when it came to Avalonian Dungeons, I did one like 6 months ago, something like that, before I was in Arch. And I remember pretty much to get to the boss, to progress in the dungeon, sometimes you have to break a wall, like an energy wall, you know? And whenever you break that wall, a text appears on the screen saying a gate has been breached. It's really cool. So we breached that gate, we went forward, we were at the final boss, I think, or something like that. We were chilling, just fighting, it was like a tier 6 Avalonian, something like that. And at some point, we saw in the middle of our screen, a gate has been breached. That was and will probably forever be the coolest moment I've ever had in Albion Online, honestly. Like, just to know that, brother, there's a 20-man group coming to get you right now. It's so cool and you don't know, should you way out? Should you stay there? Do we fight? Do we run? What are we doing? It's just priceless. But this has a very high entry point, so just know, you might not be able to do it now, but it's something to work towards if you enjoy PvE in Albion Online. Now, something that you can get a little bit easier in and that can progress to about as high as Avalonian raids, to be honest, are hardcore expeditions. This is 100% safe. Hardcore expeditions are a type of, think about it as a raid encounter, kinda. You go into the city, there's an NPC that you have to give a map to. Now, after you give that map to the NPC, you and your team will be teleported to a raid instance, where you have to kill the mobs in a specific time. If you don't manage to kill those mobs in that specific time, you will lose the map. Now, I know, you might be wondering, why do I need to care about losing the map? Well, those maps go from level 1 to level 18, I think. And they progress in difficulty like crazy. If you buy a level 1 map, let's say, you probably paid like 5k for it. A level 2 map, let's say it's 10k. And a level 18 map can be up to like 4 million silver, I think, something like that. It gets crazy. So when you enter the dungeon, you are running the risk of losing the map if you don't do it in time. But what happens if you actually do it in time? Well, in that case, you leveled up your map from level 1, let's say, to level 2. A lot of people actually do this. They take a level 1 map or like a level 5 map, something like that, and they level it up all the way to 18, selling it for a huge amount of profit. But you need the best group for this. This, while being very easy to get into for the low levels, is very hard to get into for the high levels. You need 8.3 masterpiece gear. But knowing the fact that you won't ever lose it because everything is done in the city, you don't have to go out in the city, not even in the yellow zone, you're not risking much. But at the same time, you are risking a lot because you might pay for a map like 3 mil and you might lose it at the end. So technically, You are risking about as much as people in the black zone, but at least you won't lose your gear. A lot of people actually make it a life goal in Albion Online just to be able to craft themselves the hardcore expedition set, which again needs to be 8.3 masterpiece. Good luck doing that. I mean, if you are persistent enough, I'm sure you can do it. You know, when I started playing this game, I used to be mainly a PvE player, and I know for a fact that I had a blast in Albion Online. It was really fun to just go roam the open world, kill some mobs, then go into a solo dungeon, even with a group, because come on, why wouldn't you go with a group if you want to? Just go, kill the bosses, go into a group dungeon, mess up a lot of times and wipe, get a legendary chest and be frustrated because you cannot kill the boss because you have a bad group. It's just, honestly, one of the funniest moments I have in Albion Online were in PvE, but my PvP brothers, don't you think I forgot about you? This video is part of a series in which we're gonna cover everything there is in Albion Online for each type of player. And in my mind, there's three types of player. The PvE player, the PvP player, and the casually laid back player. This is just part one for the PvE player. Stay tuned for part two, we're gonna be focusing on the PvP player. That's my favorite topic. That being said, stay tuned for it. See y'all tomorrow, bye!